Hello friends, welcome to Geometric Dimensioning and Tolerancing lecture 4. In this lecture, we will discuss what is the meaning of zero at MMC or LMC on GTOL frame and circularity, cylindricity form tolerances. Apart from that, we will also learn what is free state and restrained state of GTOL applications. Let us discuss what is zero tolerance at MMC or LMC. We have already discussed that what is the meaning of application of MMC or LMC modifier in GTOLs. But let us discuss what is zero at MMC symbols means. Suppose the diameter is 10 plus or minus 1 and we have applied this GTOL on this diameter, that is zero at MMC with datum A. So in this scenario, when the shaft or hole will be manufactured at its MMC, its perfect form state will be needed. So what if it is a shaft, its MMC will be 11 mm and we will get zero form variation in that case. And as it departs from MMC, that is 10, we will have GTOL of the amount of departure, that is 1 mm, and if it will be manufactured at its LMC, then we will get maximum form variation, that is 2 mm over here. So that is how zero at MMC or LMC in the GTOL frame means. Same as when it will be on LMC basis, LMC will be important for us. So at LMC there will be zero tolerances. Going towards MMC, we will get maximum we will get on MMC. So that is what means when we apply zero tolerance at MMC or LMC basis.
Let us discuss form tolerances like circularity and cylindricity.
Let us discuss how circularity is applied on the drawing and what does it means. So circularity symbol is a circle and we apply on the axis over here, or we can put the arrow over here also. So what does it mean? It means that when a plane perpendicular to the axis will cut off this cylinder, all the points on the surface must lie within this tolerance zone. So I take a section over here and this is my tolerance zone in black lines. So all the points of this cylindrical surface should lie within these tolerance zone. It should not violate, like it should not go below this, and it should not go away from this. So this is how circularity means. Same way, circularity can be applied on a conical surface. Like this, if we apply circularity on this, what does it mean? It means similarly as we discussed, if we cut it in a section perpendicular to the axis, all the point on this surface must lie within the tolerance zone specified over here. So this is the tolerance zone of 0.5 inch or mm, and all the points on this surface should lie within this tolerance zone. So we can cut it at different sections and we can measure the deflection, and the deviation should not cross the limit, that is 0.5 mm. So that is how it means. Circularity can be also applied on a sphere. Suppose this is a sphere and we have applied a circularity on this 0.5. What does it mean? It means that with its center point, any plane passes through it and cut this sphere, and we take section over there. All the point on this surface, on the section, should lie within this tolerance zone. So tolerance zone will be for this, that is 0.5. So similarly, I can cut at many places as I want passing from this center. So this is how circularity applied on sphere and what does it mean. Let us discuss how cylindricity is applied on the drawing and what does it mean. So suppose this is a pin and we have applied cylindricity on it. Cylindricity symbol is like two parallel lines and a circle within it. So we have given 0.5 inch of cylindricity symbol on this part. What does it mean? So in the cylindricity, the envelope of the tolerance zone is two cylinders. So with one cylinder having a 0.5 inch radius more than other cylinder, and both are concentric cylinder with a axis. So if we can see all the point on this surface should remain within this tolerance zone, that is 0.5 inch. So cylindricity is a composite tolerance that controls straightness, that controls circularity, and also it controls taperness. So cylindricity is composite tolerance or composite GTOL of, that is combination of straightness, circularity, and taperness. So it controls all these three. And the envelope is two concentric cylinder having one having radius more than 0.5 inch, that is specified tolerance, with comparing with other cylinder. And remember that in circularity or cylindricity, the tolerance zone should always less than this tolerance. So it should be always less than this tolerance value, because in this MMC is respected and it should not violate the law, the rule 1 in GTOL. And another thing, this circularity and cylindricity do not apply with modifiers, that is MMC modifier or LMC modifier. Let us discuss how cylindricity and circularity measured and how it is differentiated. So suppose this is the part we want to measure the circularity. We will held it by some means and we will revolve it. So whatever the maximum and minimum reading we will get on a particular section, that will be circularity error. Suppose it goes to minus 1 to plus 2. So that will be from 1-3 of circularity error. And then we will move it some other place and we will check how, and this part will be revolved. So what is the deflection in dial gauge? Suppose it goes to minus 0.5 to minus plus 1. So that will be around 1.5 of circularity error. So this is how circularity measured. In cylindricity, what happens? I will put dial gauge over here and I will rotate it. So suppose I get deflection of minus 1 and this is 1. So this is overall 2. And now I will put dial gauge at another place and I will revolve it. I get the reading minus 2 and I get over here 1. So how cylindricity will be combined? The extreme of 2 will be taken. So minus 1, minus 2, extreme is minus 2, and this both are 1. So the difference is 3. The cylindricity error is around 3 by this. So we will combine all the reading and then measure the cylindricity. Whereas in this case, particular section, as we circularity is a particular section, so the readings will be not clubbed, the error will be measured in this way. So this is how we can differentiate while we measuring circularity and cylindricity.
The next question is, what is the meaning of specifying circularity in a free state?
So let us discuss what is meaning of applying GTOL when component is given at free state. What does it mean, free state? Suppose we are manufacturing some large diameter but with thin sections. So while manufacturing, there are some pressures on it, so it deforms. So free state means when all those forces are removed from that, what will be the size of component? In that case, circularity or cylindricity can violate the rule, like the tolerance amount should be below the tolerance zone. It can cross that. Like in this case, the tolerance is only 5 mm, whereas circularity can be given 10 mm on free state. And this is the circularity symbol based on average diameter. So these two extreme cases has been explained. It will be applicable on all manufactured sizes like 1304 mm or 1302 mm. I have two extreme cases, that is 1305 and 1300. So in case of 1305, what will be the tolerance zone? Tolerance zone will be 1305 plus 10, that is 1315 and 1295. So circularity, all the points on this surface should remain within this tolerance zone. And again, when it will be manufactured at LMC, that is 1300. So the tolerance zone will be 1310 and 1290, and circularity should be within that. So this is free state application of circularity or cylindricity.
Now, what is specifying tolerances at restraint state? So where geometric tolerances are to be verified with the part in restrained condition, that is the forces those were applied during manufacturing should be applied during measurement also. We have to select certain features as a datum features. Those should be held during measuring. In some time, we have to give the required forces also to restrain the features.
Thank you for watching the video. The next video in this series will cover the datum and datum simulations. Thank you.